What's up, my LS crazed amigos? It's your boy Terry, speaking from the garage shop once again. Here to offer you some more big bang for the buck product and info. Yeah, y'all know what's up with the Trailblazer. Y'all know what's up with the SS. What I'm doing today is I'm plumbing the supercharge system, because as we all know, you saw this in the video, the four components of cooling the supercharger. You have your top, you have your reservoir, you have your pump down there, and you have your heat exchanger, all right? So what I wanna do is, before I start this car up, what I wanna do is, I was just putting water, don't think it was antifreeze yet, but it's water, because what I do is I test it to see if there's any leaks, and I wanna make sure that the flow goes, and like I said, just to make sure that there's no leaks and I don't have any issues, because water's a lot easier to clean than antifreeze or whatever you use to cool your supercharger. Some people use a 40 below, some people use antifreeze, whatever. So that's what I'm gonna do today. I'm gonna plumb the system, and I'm gonna make sure that everything is copacetic and before I fire it up, all right? So come here, let me show you something. Now this is my reservoir, and I got this from PCM of North Carolina. It's really slick, it fits right in the position where that old, nasty, ooh, terrible looking, ooh, windshield wiper fluid reservoir used to sit, so it makes it nice and clean. And for my windshield wiper reservoir, there it is right there. You know, again, PCM of North Carolina, they hooked the brother up. So, but like I said, I was putting water in here, as you can see. See, there's water in there, and I like to have it going through the system first before I fill it up with some type of, you know, any type of coolant. But let's go over the key components. Like I said, you got your reservoir, you got your top, you got your pump that's down there, and you got your heat exchanger. Let's see, there it is right there. Most supercharger pumps are not pusher pullers, they're mostly pushers. When I say that, I mean they push the water through the system. They don't suck it in to the pump, no. So what you're gonna have to do is, if you have a system, like you got your reservoir, and from your reservoir, the fluid should go to the pump. Now, if you have your pump above the reservoir, like I said, it's not a pusher, so it's not gonna suck the water into the pump. You're gonna have to have, you know, gravity drop that water down. And so remember, when you have your reservoir, your pump should be lower than your reservoir, so the water will go to the pump, and then at that point it's in the pump, and the pump will push the water out, and it's the circle of supercharger life. So what we're gonna do right now is, this is the power and the negative to the water pump. We're gonna put a little power to the water pump, and we want to see if that water is going to start swishing around in the reservoir. So let's see, got your negative. You hear that? See? There it goes. So now I know my pump works, and there's fluid going throughout my system. So I'm gonna turn it off. All right. Last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna check for leaks. Yep, see, I found a little leak. You see a little water right there? All right, so let me see. Yeah, it's gotta be coming from here, from that AN fitting. All right, so I continue to run the pump for another couple of minutes, and I don't see any other leaks other than that AN fitting right there. So I think it's probably just gonna be a thing where I need to tighten it up. So what I did was got my big open end, and I'm gonna try to tighten it up. But before I do, I don't wanna scuff the beautiful paint job on that AN 12. So it's pretty loose, but let's check it out now. Let's dry it off. Put a little bit more power to it. More power to you. Still seems dry, that's a good sign. So what I'll do is I'll come back in a couple of hours and check and see if there's any water spots down at the bottom of the reservoir. And if not, we're golden. Okay, it's about 4 hours later, still dry. So I'm hoping, keep my fingers crossed, that I solved the problem, but I'm pretty sure I did, but I'll definitely check tomorrow morning just to make sure. Yeah. So that's how I go about plumbing the system, you know, and I want to give a special thanks to PCM of North Carolina for hooking a brother up with the reservoir and the windshield wiper reservoir as well. And not only that, they hooked me up with the electric fan. Now remember, if you like these videos, if you like what I'm doing here, because I got more projects coming to hit you with. That's right. If you like these projects, if you like what I'm doing, hit the subscribe button and also that little bell. If you want to be notified when Coverman 66 puts a video out, you want to hit that bell. There's a bell right next to the description. Let's do it together right now. Hit the subscribe, bam, and then hit the bell, boom. Because that will notify you when I put a video out. And you won't miss them because, like I said, I got tons of videos coming out. I'm going to hit you with. I got new projects and I got other special surprises in store. But I'm looking at the clock on the wall, or should I say ceiling, and it's time for me to head on off. As always, please be easy, and I'll catch you guys real soon. Take care.